Modern coaching thinking has roots that go back way beyond modern writers and 20th century pioneers of coaching. Coaching is as much a philosophy as it is a set of practical tools. It therefore shouldn't come as any surprise that the underpinning concepts of coaching can be traced back to the leading philosophers who played a significant role in shaping our cultural heritage. So, are the true forefathers of coaching actually Socrates, Plato, and Aristotle? Socrates' focus was, as he described it, the cultivation of the soul, criticizing self-interest in favor of a life better lived by centralizing values, morals, ethics, and a dialogue of argument that strove to ask better questions. Socratic questioning sits at the heart of coaching today. Questions that alert a person to what they already know or what they might learn. Plato then followed a path influenced by Socrates, having been part of a group of young people who engaged with him during his own early learning. When Plato formed his own opinions, he argued that people were too inclined to take things at face value and didn't question enough. He sought better answers by asking better questions and recognized in the answers the value of deeper understanding. The sign above the entrance to his academy read, "Let no one who is ignorant of geometry enter here," as by following the work of Pythagoras, he took note of naturally occurring numbers and shapes that hold both meaning and power. He questioned the environment as well as the people in it and sought deeper answers. Whereas Socrates merely expounded the ideal of living a good life, Plato added to this by seeking to define and understand what a good life meant and how it might be lived. Aristotle joined Plato's academy when he was aged 18, stayed 20 years and went on to tutor Alexander the Great. He differed and clashed with Plato, believing that to live and attempt to understand was not enough, but that this understanding must be applied and used. He held that through movement and application, a person could achieve this goal of a better life. Aristotle would teach his students as they strolled together through the Lyceum, using the movement of walking to reinforce his approach. His was a peripatetic school, making movement with discussion analogous to thinking with intent and action. The 10 predicates he's known for distinguish fundamental concepts used to break down experience and reality into a complex analysis of what is. He believed in the inquiring mind and the power of curious questioning. Happiness, he advocated, is an activity and not a state or a thing. Thank you.